of my sharing is rejoicing at the marvelous things God has done. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When you read the gospel according to St. John, chapter 1, you find that John is explaining the glorious gift that the Word of God, the Logos of God, Jesus Christ, is to us. He explains that it is Jesus through whom the world was created, through whom you were created. It is Him who made everything to come to life. And also, the scriptures explain that after the devil had come in and the children of God had fallen out of God's glory, for the Bible says, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. After the fall, it is the same Logos, the same Word of God, the same Jesus Christ who came to redeem humanity and bring them back to God and to their rightful place as the apple of God's eye. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It says that this word is light. So when you have the Word of God, Jesus Christ, you will walk in the light. It also says that this same Word is life. Without the life, there is no living. The Bible says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Without the truth, there is no knowing. Without the way, there is no going. And without the life, there is no living. And so we ought to rejoice and live a life full of praise for what God has done. The same person who created us, after the fall, He came to give us new life. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says He came to His own, but His own received Him not. But those who received Him, those who believed in Him, He gave them the power to become God's children. And the Ephesian passage is explaining that being God's children in a wonderful way. The Ephesian passage provides an antiphonal response to the first chapter of John's Gospel, revealing the importance of all those divine characteristics through the Word, through Jesus Christ, the one who has made us God's children. We mortal ones are blessed and chosen and are redeemed, adopted and redeemed, gathered together, made heirs of God, and we are marked with the seal of His promise, the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. So John explains the Logos, the Word of God, Jesus, how He created the world and how He has brought new life. And then in Ephesians, Paul responds by saying how wonderful it is for us, the children of God, because now those of us who are nobodies have been made into somebody because of Christ. Those of us who are no people have been made into the people of God because of Jesus Christ. Those of us who had no future have a promise in Jesus Christ, who says, I will be with you whatever you need. And Paul makes a confession and says, because of Christ, he can face all situations through Christ who gives him strength. I know some of you are rejoicing when your children passed KCPE and some of them passed the KCSE. You are rejoicing, but your rejoicing was short-lived because you came to realize you will need to pay more fees than you were paying last year. So your rejoicing came short, but I want to tell you that our God can you at your points of need and bless you with his riches in glory. And for that reason, you should not be lugubrious and feel like you are apologizing for your existence. You should rejoice because God is on your side. Praise the Lord. Jeremiah tells us the right response we should have towards what God has done. Jeremiah tells us that we need to rejoice. So Jeremiah provides us with a clue as to how we should or ought to respond to such glory and such grace, to such truth and such redemption. Those who were separated are now brought together. Those who are scattered have been brought close. And so Jeremiah says, shout for joy, rejoice, because your God has gathered you back to him. And the Bible tells me that Jesus Christ has come, that one day we may be all together in one with Christ as the head. He will have crushed the last enemy, the devil, and death, and he will bring us together. Therefore, you need to live a life full of praise. Praise the Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.